Hi, and welcome to Grafana's OpenTelemetry Operator and auto-instrumentation tutorial. So let's get started. Now, the first thing you'll see here on my desktop is a standard Grafana Cloud instance. This happens to be my test instance, and there's very little that's been configured here so far. And we'll head over to the Application Observability function. Application Observability is a new feature inside of Grafana Cloud that allows you to see all of your services across any type of application workspace. Now, here we have a inventory or service catalog of applications that are automatically discovered. You'll see in the last 30 minutes, there have not been any applications deployed in my environment. Now, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna go ahead and move towards my Kubernetes cluster. And what you'll see here is just a standard Kubernetes cluster that happens to live in AWS EKS. And I've also pre-installed the Grafana Alloy agent technology to collect all of the telemetry signals from my applications. Now, before we actually see any data inside of the Grafana Cloud instance, we first have to deploy that app and then we have to instrument it properly. There are many different ways to instrument your app. You can do it through manual instrumentation or auto instrumentation. And then of course you need to also set up that auto instrumentation. So we're going to use a technique to actually do that for us in a slipstream manner. So that's called the OpenTelemetry Operator, and let me show you how that works. So let me go over to my OpenTelemetry Operator installation. We're going to go ahead and use the Helm chart command. So the expectation in this video is that you have some familiarity with things like Helm and kubectl. And if you don't, there are some links below, again, that you can follow along if you want to learn more. So I'm going to go ahead and execute this command. And it's going to install the OpenTelemetry Operator. And there it goes. So the OpenTelemetry Operator is now deployed into my Kubernetes cluster. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to install something that's called a custom resource. Now, a custom resource in Kubernetes is a more advanced topic, but in order for the OpenTelemetry Operator to understand what to instrument in the applications, we do need to install this specialized instrumentation object. And it has been created. Now, anytime I deploy an app inside of Kubernetes, it will automatically detect that app and then instrument it appropriately. Now, there's one additional step. Again, it is listed in the steps in the tutorial below, is that we will have to ensure that we annotate the app. So we're going to go ahead and look at the YAML manifest for this application. In this case, the application is called Hello World Node.js app.yaml. And if we take a look at this, it's a deployment using a standard Node.js test app from this image repository. But the most important piece here is that we're adding an annotation. This annotation effectively instructs the OpenTelemetry Operator to inject the appropriate SDKs in order to instrument this app. And we'll show you more about how that looks once we get started. Now, one last thing, this deployment includes a service, and the service is designed to be able to talk to a distributed set of these Node.js apps. So let's go ahead and deploy this app. Using the kubectl command. There we go. And we will see now that the app is getting deployed. And if we navigate over to one of these deployed pods and we scroll all the way down to the bottom, we'll see that the app was successfully deployed in a single pod, but also there was an init container, meaning a container that spun up to do a specific task, was also initiated to inject the instrumentation based on the annotation that we declared inside of the application YAML. And once that job was completed, the init container is spun down and no longer needed. So if we go back to our pods, we can see that we have our app running along with a service right here. And now we will head back over to my Grafana Cloud instance. Okay, so now we're back to my Grafana Cloud instance, and we will go ahead and look at the last hours worth of data, and boom. Now we have my Hello World app has been discovered in the service catalog, and I can go ahead and drill in and look at the red metrics for this newly deployed app in my Kubernetes cluster. We could see things such as the latency metrics, the error metrics, the rate metrics, and then we also see the upstream and downstream services that are connected to my Hello World app. Very useful. Now, if I wanted to drill in, I could also look at the trace data for this app, sort by duration. We can drill into a trace. We can look at the logs. We can look at the profiles. We can also pivot to the underlying infrastructure that's hosting this app. Very useful. So here are the pod infrastructure metrics. So now I can very quickly correlate different attributes or different telemetry signals that are emanating for this particular service. And that's pretty much it. So appreciate you taking the time to listen to my video tutorial, and I look forward to gathering your feedback. Take care. Bye.